extremely confident that we're advancing some of the
Mr. Fijian, as you know, media reports have pointed out that until now, consensus has been eluding the RCEP negotiations because one or two countries, I think India was mentioned, had very specific objections to completely tariff-less trade. Now, have you resolved all the disputes that have been outstanding over the last few years? Is it all ready for signatures by the ministers? Or are there still some details that are left to be negotiated?
Thank you. In FTA negotiations, there will always be challenges. Particularly in this particular FTA, the RCEP FTA, that involves 16 countries. Where the 16 countries have different levels of economic development. You have countries like Australia, New Zealand, Japan, Korea, and China on one side. And you have countries like Cambodia, Laos, and Myanmar on the other end. And as we always say, that free trade must also be accompanied by fair trade. And by that, what we mean is, in any FTA negotiations, the different levels of economic development of those parties involved have to be taken into consideration. You are right in pointing out that the RCEP negotiations have now gone on to the fifth year. I would say we have managed to resolve most of the issues. But one thing I must say is, the conflict between US and China have actually provided an impetus to the early conclusion of RCEP. In Jakarta, all of us agreed that there is now a renewed momentum due to the conflict between US and China, where these 16 member countries have agreed that we should conclude the RCEP as soon as possible. Also, in view of the fact that there will be some of the governments, even in ASEAN, they'll be going for the new or fresh elections next year. So while we take note that by having new governments, there might be new priorities, but we believe that as far as RCEP is concerned, the consensus among all the economies is to have a substantial conclusion by the end of the year. You mentioned about India. I would say that India, together with a few other economies, they do have certain issues. But during my discussion with my Indian counterpart, I can sense that they are more amenable now. And I think this is because of the impact of the conflict on their economy. As you know, India will be also going into their elections next year. So they will also want to conclude this as early as possible. So that is a sense that we get. And this weekend, we were having our Ministers of Trade meeting to resolve some of these issues and to provide direction for the negotiators to move forward. And we are expecting some sense of direction as well from our Prime Minister when he attends the ASEAN Summit in November, as most of the ASEAN leaders would like to hear from our Prime Minister as to his views on the way forward for ASEAN. And as you would know, that our Prime Minister will also be in Bali for the IMF annual meeting, where one of the things that he will be addressing is in terms of a future trade policies, not only for this region, but globally as well.